I wanted tech news, but not like this. Like this. Optane memory, an important part of every PC, or at least Intel hopes to get there someday. And the company has unveiled Optane DC persistent memory, oh, it's a tongue twister, in the form of standard DDR4 modules with capacities of 128, 256, and 512 gigs. Now that's pretty cool. Unlike normal RAM, Optane DDR4 isn't as fast, but it's persistent, meaning that these, like, memory modules will retain data even when the system is powered down. That means that it could be used as both RAM and storage. Intel says that this will eliminate the need to wait for data to be moved between the two and increase the amount of memory available for processors to work with. These first modules will only be available on Intel's next-gen Xeon platform, but if it spreads to the mainstream, this could fundamentally change PCs as we know them. We should eliminate all sorts of redundant things, like where, no, socks and sandals are not redundant.
Yeah, they're just
the sandals keep your feet protected from staples on the floor, and the socks protect other people from the smell of your feet. Oh, crap.
What?
Ed, can you grab me the TechLink shirt?
Or is it?
We only have one? Oh, there, that's better. The names and clock speeds of four new Ryzen processors have leaked online thanks to a motherboard compatibility list posted by ASRock. The document lists the Ryzen 3 2300X, Ryzen 5 2500X, and some other ones that we'll just put on here. While these E-series chips are likely to be low power versions of the 2600 and 2700, as they're sporting a 45-watt TDP, the 2300 and 2500Xs look like they're aimed at budget overclockers and enthusiasts. We likely won't need to wait much longer to hear about these, as they'll probably show up at Computex next week. But will they be enough to take on AMD's fiercest rival, Qualcomm?
Wait, what?
Yes, that's right, Qualcomm, nice segue. Maker of primarily mobile chips is poised to come up in a big way in the PC space. Microsoft has been working to create full desktop-grade Windows 10 devices based on ARM chips, and it looks like ASUS is working on just such a device, codenamed
Primus.
It will reportedly be based on Qualcomm's Snapdragon 1000 chip, which will be powerful enough to drive desktop experiences. Just like ARM's A76 CPU, which they announced yesterday. We're even seeing native 64-bit ARM-based apps pop up. VLC just released a compatible version of their video player. Is there anything VLC can't do? So get ready to compute on your phone or call people on your PC. I mean, you can do both of those things already, but this time it'll be different.
Yes!
Trust me.
No.
Now it's time for BitQuits. Haha, I didn't say it. BitQuits.
BitQuits.
Brought to you by our merch. Except our merch really needs some feedback. I mean, a lot of you actually bought this thing, and we do want to make more stuff that you guys will actually want to buy, but we can't rely on pure meme lord grade memeness all the time. So click the link below to fill out our merch program feedback survey and let us know what you want to see on the store page. I can imagine some of you suggesting things that are a little bit too outside the box, like we can't do a flamethrower or anything, but you know, the sky's the limit, sort of.
Elon Musk did it.
All right. Much has been made of NVIDIA's allegedly plan to release its next-gen GPUs in July, but a talk from the company has been spotted on the schedule for the Hot Chip Symposium in August, titled NVIDIA's Next-Gen Mainstream GPU. So even if we don't get the 1180 in July, keep your pants warm for August. They probably will be already. Yay summer, except we have a global audience, okay? The Australians are not appreciating this right now.
Sorry.
Xiaomi has unveiled the Mi 8, a pretty accurate iPhone 10 knockoff right down to the rear camera design. But then they also have a transparent back version which may just reveal an internal sticker that looks like the actual phone's internals, but oh, they were so close to jerry-rig everything's dream phone. They were so close. Visa's payment network went down across vast swaths of Europe today, leaving customers unable to pay with things via credit card, like that $4 word I just used. I guess Visa isn't everywhere you want to be. because that's their slogan. I actually didn't even know. You wrote in the script that I didn't know that, but I didn't know that. While other companies are working on AI assistants, Walmart is perfectly happy just using people. Their new Jet Black service allows you to order products by texting, not to an AI, but to a personal shopper, a real flesh and blood person with thoughts and feelings, and maybe acne. But isn't that amazing? After some leaks, Ubisoft has revealed the next game in the Assassin's Creed series, Odyssey, with a GIF of some guy getting enthusiastically kicked off a mountain in reference to the movie 300. Hopefully this game doesn't have Greek people with Scottish accents though. I don't think that that would be historically accurate.
But fun.
Well, all things must end eventually, and that's what happened to this episode. It ended, eventually. I can't believe it dragged on this long, you poor people. So subscribe to TechLink for your tech news, and also for your jimmies. Don't forget those, jimmies are important. You mean penises?
No.
Cause I...
You know, like jimmies, do it for the jimmies.
Do it for the, I have...
Where do you get your jimmies? Let me know.
And that's where it ends.